Ladies and gentlemen, many songs have been written, and this is one of them.
You're listening to Almond in the Morning, Common Sense Radio.
Yes, everybody. Hey, Jay Stewart, you know what? I missed you at the U-City Homecoming, man.
Oh, what's up, man?
I missed you at the U-City Homecoming.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I was working some shows.
I was the Grand Marshal, man. It was embarrassing not to have my supporters out there.
That's awesome.
No, it was cool. It was so cool to go back there and see the old school and just the students, and it was a ton of fun. It was truly an honor to be part of that parade, I'll tell you. So
right, absolutely.
Those guys are doing well. Their football team, it's a little rough. You know, I didn't realize, you know, they're the same size that they were when we were going to school there. It's still 800 students basically. But you know, they play like a team like Parkway West or something like that, and they've got 1,200 students or 1,600 students at their school.
Right.
And, you know, it's kind of hard to do that. All right, so anyway, this McMullen dude, what are you talking about with Evan McMullen?
Well, I think, you know, as you know, I like Gary Johnson, but I have to be honest, like you, I think maybe you had some favor for him too. I don't think the guy is uninformed, and I don't think that he is a dummy, but I do think that he's a little bit aloof when it comes to actual campaigning. And when you go into Chris Matthews' interview, you know Chris Matthews is a huge Hillary Clinton supporter.
Yeah.
And when you're going to say she's going to shoot, you know, he's at some point he's going to press you on something on an international level. Again, I think Gary Johnson's answer to Bernie Sanders absolutely dishonest. I do think Clinton's right about this. Bernie Sanders tries to manipulate the economic anxieties of young people by offering free college. Johnson gave a beautiful answer. That's going to bankrupt the private colleges and create rationing.
Yeah. Well, let's
go ahead.
Well, Hillary wants to do that too.
Well, Hillary Clinton, of course, did what the Democratic platform, she was afraid of the impact, and that's one thing I don't like about the party system. She caved on that. You know, I mean, her plan's a little bit more measured than his, but yeah, it's a bad idea. But I think when it comes to foreign policy, I think he's just, the fact that he told people he smoked pot a lot is going to be used against him when he can't remember stuff. And I think it's unfair, but it's the reality. I'm even with people I like, I'm not going to give them passes. The same way I don't give Trump passes when he says absurd stuff. So
yeah,
I think he was legitimately, I actually think Weld is a better candidate than he is personally. I think his VP candidate strikes me as significantly sharper.
Yeah.
And significantly more on the ball.
Well, yeah, it's true. And I don't know, McMullen, you know, he doesn't hold any rallies or anything. He's just kind of like goes and is interviewed. But all right, man, well, I'm glad we finished this one up. TheGreatFalcon.webs.com.
Okay.
Thanks again for everything, man. And I'll get right now to Rob Ray.